Well, good evening, everybody. How's everyone doing? Welcome to everybody on Facebook Live. We're having our prayer for the nation. Since last week, we had our concert with Kevin and Heidi, which was wonderful. And so now we're kind of back to our normal routine again. So praise the Lord. And we'll have our prayer for our nation. Praise God. And our praise report is that Pastor Patsy and Lisa made it here fine. Pastor Allen made it here ahead of schedule yesterday, about a quarter till 12 with the U-Haul truck. And we had enough people to unload everything. Got done about 2:30 yesterday afternoon. And then Pastor and Lisa got, Paul and Lois went and got them. And they got here about a quarter till 11 last night. So they're busy, busy. They've been working today on getting everything done. And so that's where they're at. But Lisa hopes to maybe come by later and say hi to people. So hopefully, and then Pastor will definitely be here Sunday. But I think she's going to spend her first night in her apartment tonight. And she said she loves it. So I'm glad to hear that. She says, I love my apartment. It's a little small, and I'm going to have to get rid of a few things, she said. but she, bless her heart, she has a really good attitude. But she's really happy to be back to Superior. So praise the Lord. I know you all just love on her. And just remember, you know, that it did cost quite a bit of money for her to move here. So the moving expenses, it's around, we need about $2,000, and we have about maybe $200 or $300. So praise the Lord. God is a big God, so he will provide. I'm not going to put pressure on anybody, but I just think sometimes it's good to let people know what the need is. So money, and if you haven't looked at gas prices lately, you understand, right? So think, what's that? Yes, even though I was a very small U-Haul truck, but Tim and Ivan could tell me, there's a lot of stuff in there, wasn't there, Ivan? He packed a lot into that little truck, so praise the Lord. Well, let's just have a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for everyone that's here to pray. We thank you for all that you're doing in our lives, and that you take care of us, and we just thank you for, we lift up Royce and Nancy tonight. We thank you that Nancy's symptoms are gone, healed and whole in Jesus' name. Royce will have no symptoms and they'll be able to be out and about very, very soon. We just thank you for that. Take care of the youth. And they're not able to meet tonight, but just bless them, Father, and help them just to draw closer to you. And thank you for your presence in their lives, and you help them. And they remember those things that they've been taught. And we just thank you for all that you're doing in our lives, Father. And we just thank you for your strength, for your help, for your anointing. It's the anointing that destroys the yoke of bondage. And we just receive all that you have for us tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Thank you for being here tonight. One can put 1,000 to flight, and two can put 10,000 to flight. And boy, we need some of those evil forces put to flight.
Here.
Nick's song was written in 1944. And boy, did they pray. They prayed and prayed and prayed right then, didn't they? And look at how many years of wonderful prosperity this land has had. It's our turn. Be very sure.
Father. We just worship you tonight and we praise you. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord Jesus. We worship you. We praise and we thank you tonight. We love you, Lord. We love you so much, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We glorify your holy name. Thank you, Father. Glory to your name, Lord. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Oh, we love you, Jesus. We praise you. We bless you. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you for your presence tonight. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your presence in our lives. Praise you, Lord Jesus. We worship you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. We praise you. We bless you. You're so good, Lord. You're so good. You're so good. Thank you, Father. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. We worship you, Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We do worship you. We do thank you. We do bless you. We do praise you. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. God is so good. Amen. Thank you. God is working. God is working. Don't listen to the lie that the devil would say he's not, or God can't handle it anymore. No. God is working. God is working in my life. He's working in your life. His plan, God's plan, is coming to pass. His plan is coming to pass. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. It shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. Oh, yes. Yes, yes. His plan shall come to pass. And I want to be a part of that plan. Now, that's where you have your freedom of free will. God is doing his plan and it shall come to pass. Now, whether you will be doing the part that God called you to do or not, that's up to you. So my plan will come to pass with God's plan. Amen. I will do what God's called me to do. I will fulfill what God's called me to fulfill. I'll be the person that God's called me to be. That's what you need to say. I'll do, Lord, what you call me to do. I'll be where you want me to go. I'll say what you want me to say. Thank you, Lord. And I know that you will anoint me to do that. I am anointed right now. I am anointed to say the things that you want me to say. We thank you for it tonight, Jesus. We give you the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Oh, just a precious, sweet anointing, peaceful anointing tonight. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Well, I got a really nice thank you card from Larry and Angela Keaton. I want to read that to you. Dear Pastor John, thank you for hosting us once again in Superior. We enjoyed our stay at the Victorian Inn. It is always spotlessly clean and quiet. We were able to rest well and prepare for the meetings, and we appreciated the meals you provided, especially that you went out of your way to accommodate our low-carb diet. So they were trying to do that while they were here. It was a pleasure ministering to your church family. They're always receptive of us. We're glad God healed your shoulder and that others were healed in their knees and backs. We trust the word the Lord gave each of us was a blessing and encouragement to the people. We received your generous offering in the mail and when we returned from the rest of our trip. Thanks so much for your giving heart. We look forward to the next time we see you again. Love, Larry and Angela. Amen. So that's so sweet. Praise God. And I just want to give honor where honor's due. We want to thank Tim and Sharon for having a wonderful night for the men last night. You know, they go to a lot of work, and Sharon went to a lot of work. And I heard that Linda and Arlette got to see it. That's awesome. And Tim's message was outstanding. Every man needs, that's the only thing, we should record that somehow. I don't know how we could do it out there, but that message, oh, men need to hear that. What a godly man, you know, what they need. And he doesn't pull any punches either. He lets you know right the way it's supposed to be and gives you the word and gave a lot from Genesis. It was just awesome. And my prayer was, Lord, even if you have to put a dome up, put a dome up. And Tim was telling me last night, you know, he said last year the trees, the leaves had fallen, you know, early last year. And he was concerned about so many leaves around the fire pit. So this year they didn't do it. And it was trying to rain on us and the leaves were just catching the rain. And it was providing a dome over us. And I didn't know that that was the kind of dome that God was going to do. But it was very pleasant out there, even though I wore my jacket. But the fire pit was just wonderful. And I just appreciate a few people weren't here, you know, that were supposed to come. But I still know that a lot we all were ministered to. And I know it's just a lot of work for a small amount of time. We do appreciate it. It's really neat out there. Now we think you need to build a cabin out there, Tim. That's what the consensus was today. You need a cabin with running water. We don't ask for much. Yes, Sharon? Oh, I know. Wouldn't that be? Oh, that would have been so awesome. That would be so awesome. Yeah. We just had to say that. Praise the Lord. And one more announcement thing. We did open up the scarecrow pumpkin patch, which is on October 23rd. We opened it up to couples. We just have a few singles going. We got one couple going. So if anyone else wants to go, it's here. And we'd love to. We're going to go. I don't care if there's just a few of us. We're going to have a good old time. But just if any couples want to come along, we'd love to have you. So we're going to go to Perkins and have lunch. And then we're going to go on to the pumpkin patch. And then you get a special group rate. And you get hot dogs and whatever else it says on there. Kind of a meal for the evening on that too. So, and it'll be a fun time. So praise the Lord. Amen. Okay, and then a reminder that we will have a short meeting for the carnival at 8 o'clock, and I want it to be about 10 minutes. I think we can get done what we need, just some very simple things, and then we'll have our choir practice after that. So, if you all have your Vantage Point devotion papers here, and then we'll start with that. Romans 14:19, pursue what makes for peace and for mutual upbuilding. The word pursue implies taking effort and energy. Think of a hunter getting up before dawn, gathering his gear, going to the woods and putting in miles on foot in pursuit of the game. What would happen if believers put as much energy and effort into encouraging one another and establishing peace in the church? Ironically, the church's history is filled with violence and hatred, one faction fighting against another. But can this be defined as the church according to biblical definition? What makes for peace and mutual upbuilding? What is the responsibility of the church? Believers are called to worship and serve God, to encourage each other in faith, to give to the needy, to spread the gospel, to be a strength and support to each other, and to use whatever gifts they have to help others. Excuse me. The church is to be salt and light. Salt preserves. What God has called you to do to help preserve the Christian faith, what has God called you to do to help preserve the Christian faith throughout the generations? Salt adds flavor. Does your faith enrich your life and others' lives? Salt keeps feet from slipping on ice. Are you helping others to keep from slipping in their faith walk? Salt makes you thirsty. How can you live the Christian life in such a way that it makes people thirsty for what the Lord has given you? Light shines in the darkness to make the way plain. Are you shining his light by your actions for others to see the love Christ has for them? Pray for the church in the United States to be a place of hope, healing, and encouragement for those who need it most. And we know that's just a very important thing as Christians and as the church. The church needs to be a welcoming place. A place where people will come in and sense the presence of God, the love of God, the peace of God. Pursue what makes for peace and mutual upbuilding. It takes a little effort to do that. But I think that's what makes our church a special place, because people have told me over and over, I feel so loved when I come here. And I think that's, we have a love for each other, and we don't want to leave. Sometimes we don't want to even leave. We just fellowship for a long time. So I think it's so important in this world right now, we need to show love. We need to show peace. We need to show that we care to others. And even if it's just a special, just a hug or handshake, something, a kind word, God will use you to do that. Be open to those things for God to use you to do that in someone else's life. Amen. Don't get too busy that we just think, I got to do this, I got to do that, and then we forget to take care and help others. It's all about people. Amen. And then the presidential prayer team daily briefing today, 10:13. President Joe Biden will receive his national security briefing at the White House this morning. Then he will meet with officials to discuss global supply chain issues in the afternoon. The president has no public events on his schedule at this time. On Tuesday, the president extended the national emergency with respect to significant narcotics traffickers centered in Colombia, sending notice to the Speaker of the House and the President of the Senate of this action. President Biden declared the actions of significant narcotics traffickers centered in Colombia continue to pose an unusual and extraordinary threat to the national security, foreign policy, and economy of the United States and cause an extreme level of violence, corruption, and harm in the United States and abroad. So as the Lord leads, pray with us, and we pray for President Biden and his administration as evaluations are made regarding regional and national emergencies. Just show them, let them listen to wisdom, let them listen to others who have experience and listen to these things the best way that they can do and solve these problems. Thank you for the president to obtain wise counseling in addressing national and international supply chains. He'll listen to those who have experience. He'll listen to those who have the wisdom for this. Thank you, Lord, for Border Patrol and drug enforcement agents as they work to prevent the trafficking of narcotics. We plead the blood of Jesus over them. We claim Psalm 91. Keep them safe and protected and help them, Father, as they do their jobs. And those people will be stopped in Jesus' name. And thank you for you, Lord, to accomplish your purposes in the United States of America. You're doing your purpose and your plan in our nation, in Jesus' name. And this is on the other page. Don gave me this. And the spirit war is raging against principalities and powers, must be fought and won by believers. Today we are asking you and every friend of the nation of Israel to join us in this prayer. Keep this in your Bible or somewhere where you can easily get your hands on it as a reminder to pray. And you know, we are fighting the good fight of faith. We already have won, haven't we? The devil is defeated. So we just continue to thank God that he is a defeated foe. And we can say this together. I command you, you fallen principalities and powers that murdered the Lamb of God. But Jesus' death on the cross was not the end. It was just the beginning. Because through his suffering, he has gloriously defeated principalities and powers. Through the power of his name and the power of his blood, I command you, fallen spirits who are assigned to murder the Jewish people, be bound in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare, we declare, that every one of you evil spirits, principalities, and powers are rendered ineffective. Through the work of the cross and the blood of the Lamb and the mighty name of Jesus, you will cease and desist from your assignments. The blood of Jesus rebukes you. The God of Israel rebukes you. We declare that our God is sending angel armies to do battle against you fallen demons. We decree in the mighty name of Jesus that you will take your hands off our Facebook page. It will be restored. We will not fight with the flesh and blood, but we will declare that we will be utilizing the whole armor of God in this war, in this battle against rulers, against authorities, against the powers of this dark world and spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. We put on the full armor of God with the belt of truth buckled around our waist, with the blessed breastplate of righteousness in place, and with our feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition, we take up the shield of faith, then we declare that we extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. We take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And we are more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. Greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. All of your powers are rendered ineffective. You will surrender and submit in the mighty name of Jesus, and you will surrender quickly, and all heaven will testify of your defeat through the power of our prayer of agreement. Father, we just thank you for that. We thank you for our country, the United States of America. This is our country. This is my country, one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all. We continue to pray, Father. We thank you for revival. We thank you for the great awakening. We thank you for our country, that you're going to use the United States of America. You're using us to send missionaries all around the world. And Father, we thank you for the churches. We thank you for the Christians who are on fire for God. And we thank you, Father God, we are not going to go away. We're going to continue to do what you called us to do. And thank you, Lord, for the great harvest. We thank you for it, Father God, that we're part of that. We're part of that in Superior, Nebraska. We're part of that in the 60-mile radius. With Living Faith Fellowship Church is being used in these end time, in the end time harvest. We are, as individuals, being used in the end time harvest. And we thank you for it. And we pray and intercede tonight for our country. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. All of the people.
Father, we just want to thank you for our country. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you that you hear and answer our prayers. We thank you for it, Lord. We thank you. This is one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all. We thank you for it, Father. We praise you for our country. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you for the gospel going all throughout our country. Thank you, Lord. We claim this country for you. We claim these 50 states, Nebraska. We claim Kansas. We claim this 60-mile radius for you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for revival. Thank you for the great awakening. Thank you, Father. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for answered prayer. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for leadership. Thank you for godly leadership. Thank you for the upcoming elections, 2022, 2024. Thank you, Father. We praise you. We bless you. We worship you. We thank you. We bless you. You hear and answer our prayers. We thank you for it, Jesus. Hallelujah. And let's stand up and we're going to sing God Bless America. Hallelujah.
God bless America.
What's that? Oh, let's say the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Praise the Lord. Are there any prayer requests tonight? Yes, Kathy.
I got two
of them. Okay.
Carol Shumba.
Okay.
Tell me to tell everybody hello, and she's doing very well in her walking up there to Healthy Living. She goes every week to Healthy Living. She's very brave and going.
And she just wants continued prayer to be total recovery. I know it. I recorded. I haven't seen it yet, but I heard on the news, and they had his voice on there. He was about crying. He said it just when they left space, when they left the atmosphere, and he went into space, and the blue just disappeared. He was just in tears, just about. So, the oldest person to ever go into space, Captain Kirk. When I was a kid, I used to want my name to be Jim, because I wanted to be James T. Kirk. That's how much, but Jesus Christ is a greater than Jim Kirk ever would be. But I pray for Jim Kirk. I pray for William Shatner, that he would know Jesus as his Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Amen. So did you want prayer for anybody else, or Carol?
Yeah.
And then you just thought that was neat about William Shatner. But you want his salvation too, right?
Yeah.
We'll do that. Because I've been praying for it. He said something about, I don't know, I have to look at it again, but like he compared going to space to life after death. So he perhaps knows. I mean, that's what kind of like, okay, he knows there's life after death. So, okay, Sharon? Oh, well, I didn't do a whole lot. Bless his heart. I saw that, the little Datsun or Toyota, it's the Toyota, the little Toyota coming in. That little pickup works out pretty handy there. And Tim and Ivan, let's appreciate that too. So, yes, appreciate everybody that helped with that. I know you had a lot, but the food looked marvelous, and you did that, and I know it was a lot of work. So we appreciate it. Anybody else? Yes, Jane.
I just want to give God the glory, because yesterday my daughter's kidney transplant went very well. Oh. With it, she
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
And then did you pray this morning about the media release Governor Ricketts gave yesterday for he's seeking applicants to represent District 5 for the State Board of Education, and that is our district.
Oh.
We need a good representative.
Because the lady resigned. I heard that she resigned. I didn't realize it was our district. Well, I know of a retired teacher that would be very good. God can talk to you. I won't say any more. No, God's going to have the right person. Amen. District 5, but we need a born-again, spirit-filled, on fire for God person. Amen. Yes. Okay. Anybody else? All righty. Well, let's just pray. Father, we just thank you. In the name of Jesus, Matthew 18:19 is the prayer of agreement. We're agreeing, touching these situations in prayer. And Donald Tyler texted me
that he has a kink in his left eye and it's causing it to be blurry, and they think it's been caused by COVID, so he has to go to an eye doctor tomorrow. And he may have to have surgery. So, Father, we're just thanking you that you can just touch that eye and that kink is gone in Jesus' name, and his eye is functioning properly and functioning in perfection which you created to function. And we just speak to that left eye, and we call you normal 20/20 vision in that left eye. We just thank you for it in the name of Jesus. We thank you and call it forth in Jesus' name. And Father, Linda Hallgrimson just came down with stomach flu symptoms. So, Father, we thank you that that flu has to leave her body in Jesus' name. It will be gone. And we just thank you, Father, touching her from the top of her head to the soles of her feet. She's the healed of the Lord. And the symptoms have to leave in Jesus' name. And, Father, we thank you for Carol Shambaugh. We thank you for total recovery for her, Father God. She's able to walk. She's able to bend. She's able to move. We just thank you for touching her with your healing power. And she knows Jesus as her Savior. We thank you for it. Father, we thank you for William Shatner. Thank you, Lord, that he will come to the saving knowledge of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, his heart is open to you. And I will know that, Father God. And you will, we will know that and have confirmation of that. We just thank you for it in Jesus' name. And Father God, we just thank you for the District 5. They need applicants for the State Board of Education. Put it on the heart of the right people, the right person. Lord, you just need one person that knows that's been called to do that for such a time as this. And I thank you, Lord, for a godly person, a godly spirit-filled, born-again spirit-filled person who understands and knows what needs to be done and understands all the different things about the State Board of Education that would be qualified, a qualified person, Father. We thank you for bringing forth that right person, and we thank you for anointing them, Father, in Jesus' name. We thank you for it. In Jesus' name, we call it done. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, if you'd like to give tonight, you can get an envelope from the chair in front of you. Make your checks out to Living Faith Fellowship Church, LFFC. And our areas of giving, and we're giving above and beyond your tithe. Our missions project for this month is, I'm trying to get used to this. I keep calling it the carnival. It's the festival, okay? But I think, and I made a decision too, because Lyndall, she did all her work. She figured out the expenses that we need for the concessions. But then that would give, if we did concessions, then we'd give you another area you'd have to give. So I wanted to keep it simple. We're just going to put it all under missions, and it's all going to help the carnival, and it's going to help pay for that too. So we need $300 to help with that part of it, but just give to that, to the carnival, and it will all get covered. I think it's the simplest way to keep it that way. So, and that's under missions. So some of you did Sunday, you circled other, and you wrote fall festival. It's okay, but it gets confusing, I understand. But just this month, because the month of October, it's easier for you just circle missions. You don't have to do anything else because it automatically goes to the carnival if you do that, okay? And so we might want to make it as least confusing as possible. Don and Kathy are the ones that do all the categories, so we try to make their life as easy as possible, okay? And then if you want to help with Pastor Patsy's moving expenses, circle other right moving expenses on there, okay? So those are, and then building repair is still available too. So those are the three areas. I'm just trying not to make too much and too hard, because if we did another, there's another whole category, then they have to figure that out too. So this is just making it a lot easier for us, okay? Those are the areas, and we appreciate everyone gives. This is such a giving church. We were able to give the Changs $1,000. We were able to give, Kufi, Christians United for Israel, $1,000. And I'm talking about back-to-back plays. You guys are awesome. Living Faith Fellowship Church is awesome. All you guys who give is just awesome. So it just blesses my heart that we can give that to these ministries. Amen. You know, God. You know, I was thinking about those two young people, Heidi and Kevin. Look how talented they are. They're living in Nebraska, in a little town of Central City. I think they could go to a big city. I know Kevin has played in symphonies before. They could be making buku money. But they said this is the ministry that God has called us to do. I heard him say that because Heidi was having to take a job last year during COVID, and she's so thankful that she's back doing what she's supposed to do. And so just keep them in your prayers. You know, God will provide. And another thing I heard too last night, you know, and Kevin is from Taiwan, and they're trying to, that's Taiwan is he's from, right? Yeah. They're trying to, China's trying to annex it or take it over or whatever they're trying to do. They're trying to say that that's part of their country and Taiwan has their independence and we're not really doing anything about it as the United States. That's not right. So that should be on the, I'll put that on the prayer list because Taiwan is a sovereign nation. It's 100 miles away from China. And that's, they have their own independence and China's trying to get them. So. I know Kevin was telling me that all the young people have to serve in the military. They're just like in Israel. His brother runs a restaurant, owns a restaurant. His brother had to sell it because they only make him go for like 4 or 5 months, but he said it wouldn't be worth it. It costs so much money to keep a building, and the buildings are so hard to come by, so he had to give up his building, his restaurant, to go into the service. But then when he gets out, he wants to go back into the restaurant business, and Kevin has already served his time. Yes, we'll do that right. We'll do that right now. Keep their sovereignty. They're ramping their military. I heard something about that they were doing military exercises, right? Yeah.
Like they
yeah. Well, Father, in the name of Jesus, first of all, we do pray, and we come against China trying to take over Taiwan and take their sovereignty away from them, Father. That's, we know that's not of you, and Father, they're stopped, and those demonic spirits that are causing that are behind that, though we break those right now and call them broken down and stopped in the name of Jesus. And we thank you. We plead the blood of Jesus over Taiwan, and Father, we have promised in the past that we would protect Taiwan. And Father, I thank you that we will keep our promises as a country and do what we're supposed to do and be an ally to them, Father, as we have said we would be. So we thank you for that and we call that done in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood and all the people in Taiwan are safe and protected. In Jesus' name, we thank you for it in Jesus' name. And Father, we just thank you for the privilege of being able to give. And we just thank you, Lord, that you meet all of our needs. We call them met in Jesus' name, exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. We thank you for our own harvest, for our own personal lives, that you meet our needs. And we thank you that all the needs of Living Faith Fellowship Church are met. We give you the glory, honor, and praise. We thank you for it. We receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's say our confession together. As I tithe and give offerings, I'm believing you, Lord, for jobs and better jobs. Raises, bonus, excuse me, promotions, sales and commissions, estates and inheritances, interest and income, rebates and returns, discounts and dividends, checks in the mail, gifts and surprises, bills decreased, bills paid off, blessings and increase, and greater victories in the midst of greater odds. Thank you, Lord, for meeting all my needs, that I may have more than enough to give to promote the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. I receive the offering. Yes.
I have two
praises. Oh, good. I'll let you say them.
First is my mother. She's been on our prayer list for a long, long time, and she had surgery last month for cancer again. And I just called her on her birthday. It was October 6th, and she's cancer-free.
Praise God. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
And the other one is I had to have a tooth a molar pull last Thursday, and I told him I did not want no swelling, no excess bleeding, and it was all that come. Isn't he good?
Amen. Amen. God. Praise the Lord. Amen. God is good. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And we're glad to have Linda back and doing well. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Oh.
I don't know how to get them in. Just put them across the border in Mexico.
There you go. Put them across the Mexico border. Yep. Well, amen. Well, we'll go ahead and we thank you all for coming tonight. We thank you for those that are watching. And we'll sign off of Facebook Live. And then we will have our, you just come forward to the first few rows for the carnival. We'll do that really quick right now. What's that? Oh, there's some cookies out there too. Sharon, that's right. Thank you. Sharon brought some cookies. So those of you that are in the meeting, come here first and then we'll get cookies later. Okay. Thank you.